Hi. Welcome.
Thank you so much for having me.
Welcome.
Thank you.
So this is Pia. She's an actress, Michael. Obviously, you're
very
aware.
Very familiar. Yeah, very familiar. So it's fantastic to meet you, I have to say.
Yeah, it really is. Thank you. Yeah.
So, but tell me, how, I've been wondering for the last few years, how much do you go to church?
not a great deal, I have to say. Weddings and funerals. Not a great deal. I mean, I would have had an upbringing that had a religious ethos, I suppose. But in the last few years, I think the last time I went into a church was a cathedral in Italy, I believe, just to have a look and, you know, just at the grandeur of it. But no, I can't say.
But you came from a Christian family or a Quaker family, right?
Yeah. My family would be Catholic. I came from a Catholic family. My parents would have gone through, I suppose, they chose anyway to raise their children as Quakers.
What is the difference there, if you can explain it?
With Quakerism, Quakerism is a kind of a sect there's no clergy, there's no hierarchy. It's sometimes referred to as friends in Christ, or you know, it's like I remember it as a child being brought on Sundays, and it's everybody kind of sits facing each other, and it's an hour of silence and kind of silent reflection. And if anybody wants to contribute to in some way that they feel, if they've reflected on something that might be significant to something that happened in that week, either in world news or in local news, they often would do so. But it's an interesting one. It's very accepting of different ideas and stuff.
But how was that for you as a child to be a part of that?
When you're a child, you're kind of, you would do maybe 20 minutes as a kid, and then they would take you out to Sunday school, you know? So for me, it was just, you're just looking at the patterns on the carpet. I think as an adult, I would appreciate it a bit more. Mm. There is something in that silent reflection, which I have great admiration for it. I have great admiration as well, too. It's one of the few kind of versions of Christianity that I can think of, or certainly that I know of, that doesn't require your belief that Jesus Christ was God incarnate to be a part of the faith itself, I suppose, which is interesting to me. But
they're also involved, they're pacifists, aren't they? And what they do is they drive ambulances and things like that.
Very,
they do very brave things.
Yeah.
Extraordinary. I did once had a friend who was Quaker, and I sat once with them, and I must say I was very taken by it. Mm-hmm. I mean, I didn't go back because I had no means of doing it, but just en passant. But it's, you're quite right, it's very interesting, that the silence and the way that when you're all together communing in the same way but not saying anything, lots of things happen, don't they?
Yeah. Mm.
Could make an interesting television show as well.
We told you. Yeah. It'd be wonderful, you try it, not me.
Yeah. The central thing that I was taught, definitely, which is trying to look for the God in each person. Mm. And it's the thing that I took away from it now, I was a child, was that you're trying to look for the spark of the divine, let's say, in every individual. Mm. And so the hope being that you would treat everybody as if you when you look into another individual, you look into the mind and the face of God. And that's, you know, that's kind of, you're trying to find the spark of the divine in everybody. And as such, yeah, huge pacifists, etc. War is kind of a big no-no for Quakers.
Do you have an ambivalence towards the church in general? Do you, or are you a wholehearted supporter?
No, I mean, I suppose something that it's not, I would, it's something I tried to make clear as well too. Well, I would hope people would understand about certainly the song, like Take Me to Church. It's never so much about faith but what powerful people and what powerful men say about God and how they use that to control people's lives and how to amass power for their own benefit. Really, that was the frustration. And I think that's something that's worth criticizing and being critical of. And, you know, especially when it's an organization that has the ability, let's say with the institutionalized Roman Catholic Church, has the ability to declare infallibility. I think there's definitely, there's a good reason to remain critical of that, you know.
You've had this amazing success now with this song, and you're here with a new album tonight. It's the difficult second album.
Yes.
How often, I mean, traveling the world as you do now, how often are you back home in your hometown in Ireland?
As often as possible. I spent a very nice, quiet Christmas there. For me, it was important to kind of keep grounded and keep a foot at home. And I'm from a place called County Wicklow in Ireland, which is very, very quiet. It's close enough to the city, but it's surrounded by green and countryside, and it's quite rural in a lot of ways. But I try to get back as much as possible.
Do you also have a part of you that long to your teenage, to your young teenage years?
I wouldn't be a teenager again for anything, I don't think.
I think
teen years in general are very difficult years for everybody. I think you're stuck between the joys of childhood and the joys of adulthood, but you've one foot in both, and as such you're in between worlds. So, and for every other reason, you know, the monotonous nightmare of school, etc., and the social politics that you're being thrust into, and the social hierarchies that you're learning about, you know, how people interact. No, I wouldn't.
Who were you back then?
As a teenager. Yeah. I was a bit of a class clown, I think. I was a bit of an unfocused student who, you know, but I just messed around a lot.
You ended up studying music and you became a great singer yourself. But according to you, is the greatest singers in the pop genre, or are they in other genres?
I wouldn't say in the pop genre. I think pop has given us fantastic vocalists. For me, jazz music was always something that I fell in love with from blues music as a kid. My dad was a musician; he was a drummer. He played in a lot of blues bands, mainly as a live gigging musician. And then when he had children, then he kind of worked elsewhere. But so I came to blues music from a very young age. The kind of power in that tradition, in blues tradition and gospel tradition. And then came to jazz music, and that's a whole... I mean, it's often said blues is the common language or the common tongue of jazz.
You're going to do a song from your album now, and it's a very dark title on that album.
Yeah, Wasteland Baby.
It's a doomsday album, you say.
To a degree. I think it's a hopeful album, and there is optimism there, but I think it definitely... It kind of carries with it a sort of... Certainly, a spirit at the time, which I was, the kind of 2 minutes to midnight on the doomsday clock, let's say, where the world is sitting at the moment. That's where a lot of that comes from. So, and there's a song on the album called Wasteland Baby, which is just imagines the worst case scenario, albeit tries to look for, in the worst case scenario, of let's say imagining the end of the world. Trying to look for. Again, the warm center of the human heart, and what something that is maybe redemptive or that can be enjoyed even in the last brief moments. But there's an element of doomsday above the album, I suppose.
It's the blues.
It's the blues. A bit of the blues there.
It's the blues.
Yeah. Absolutely.
The song Movement. Yeah. What's it about?
Song Movement. It's I suppose it's kind of a song about dancing. I suppose this is. I'm never one for dancing, never one for writing dance tracks or dance songs, so I found it easier to write a song about dancing. And just, you know, if it kind of imagines, if you can imagine the singer or it's watching somebody they love just being enraptured by sound and moving to it, and it just tries to describe an appreciation of that and in its simplest form, I suppose.
Hozier, thank you so much for being here with us tonight. Your band is waiting. The stage is yours. Thank you very much.
Thank you very, very much.
Hope you enjoyed the clip. For more interesting conversations, please hit subscribe.